So those are just some of the things that can break up somebody's sleep. Now, in the residence room, we gotta remember the residence room is literally their home. So when we are in there, we are a guest, which means we knock on the door, "Hi, this is Bob, can I come in?" We ask permission to go in, we wait for permission to go in. And then once we get in there, we tell them what we're there for. We don't announce it out in the hallway because that's giving private health information out in a public area. So we wait till we get in the room till we talk to them.
What if they're sleeping?
Yeah, and the night shift and that, we still, and what I'll basically do, we still have to announce it. I won't knock per se, but I'll say quietly, "Hi, it's Bob, I'm coming in." I've still announced it. You may feel silly doing it, but that's what we're supposed to do. We're always supposed to announce our presence. One of the things that really, this sounds kind of silly, but it always worried me when I was first a nurse, okay? Because your nurses now wear colorful scrubs, you know, but we used to wear all white, you know? I was always afraid, or not afraid, but kind of, maybe afraid, yeah. I was standing at somebody's foot of their bed, and they thinking I'm an angel, and they've died, you know, and screaming like crazy. You know, I was always afraid of something like that happening. It never did, but, you know, I always thought it would. And somebody would wake up kind of groggy, kind of sleepy, and just, you know, or something like that. We go in at night, and it's just, "Hi, I'm coming in a soft voice." The person's in a coma, we still announce it. We still announce that we're coming in. So the residence room is literally their house, you know. So we've got to remember that when we're in there, we are like a guest. And they are the boss. You know, they are the most important individual in the nursing home, is the resident themselves. So some of the standard equipment is a bed, a bedside table, possibly a dresser, an over-bed table, a chair, bath basin, emesis basin, bedpan, urinal, water pitcher, privacy screen, curtain, and a call light. Okay, and that just lists some of the stuff. We always encourage people to bring stuff from home, you know, and of course room and space has a lot to basically do with it. But if they can bring stuff from home, you know, a favorite chair, whatever, it just makes it a little bit more home-like for them. That privacy curtain, we've got to remember to use it. Even if there's just one person in the room, we're in a private room, we close the door, but we still gotta pull that privacy curtain. So many people still will just come walking in the door. Not knocking, just coming right in, barging right in. And if we've pulled the privacy curtain, well, we protect them from possibly an incredibly embarrassing moment. Now, one of the things that gets forgot a lot is the window curtain. We've got to be pulling them also because, you know, you've gone around to some of your nursing homes, I'm sure, and you've seen that a lot of the windows to the residence rooms are right, there's the parking lot, right? And, you know, we'll close the door, we'll pull the privacy curtain, but we will forget about those window curtains. And then, of course, here comes in a visitor walking with a little boy, little girl, "Mommy, Daddy, look." And we're transferring somebody to bed, and an exposure happens, and, you know, they're going to go straight to the administrator's office or straight to the DON's office. So we've got to remember our protection for our privacy is also pulling those window curtains also. Of course we keep the residence room clean. You know, now housekeeping plays a role, but we do also. You know, things that, you know, a lot of our stuff that we're using today is more and more disposable. Throw it away, stuff like that. Now, once a resident leaves, you know, like say they either pass away or they get discharged and go home, then the room gets a, it used to be called a terminal disinfection or a final disinfection, but it's where it really gets super cleaned out. You know, because we've got to before another resident comes in. It's just like you. Have you ever gone to a hotel and you checked in, you paid your money, you gone to the room, and the room looked dirty?
Yeah.
It's happened to us. I've turned right back around and gone to the clerk and said, give me my money back. I'm not staying here. The bed was a mess. There was tissue in the toilet. I mean, and you gotta wonder what else, you know? And, you know, it just looked bad. Well, it's the same thing when a resident goes home or there is a discharge. That room is super clean because the next person coming in, it's got to be clean for them. Bed making and stuff like that, we're gonna talk about that in a bit here. It shows you a good picture here, a couple good pictures. When we go to the back and I talk about chucks or a blue pad, this is what I'm talking about. It's a pad where one side is absorbent and the other side is like non-absorbent. So what it does is it catches urine and it keeps it from going soaking down all the way down to the linen. So a lot of times these will be underneath your resident. They're made out of a similar material as what in briefs are made out of, incontinent pads, or for your little ones' diapers. It absorbs the liquid. And so when I talk about a chucks, that's the piece that I'm talking about right there. It's a flat pad. Now, the way this guy is carrying the linen is the right way. We're not supposed to carry it like a bunch of books tucked underneath our arm or anything like that, because there is a problem then with close contamination. 162, we'll talk in the back about the corners. 163 about putting on the pillows. At home, you may put the pillow on, the pillowcase on, and tuck the pillow on underneath your chin and pull it up. But we don't do it that way in the nursing home. One of the things is, you know, if somebody has been coughing in bed, and they've been coughing on that pillow, do you want this far from your mouth what they've been coughing on? No, of course not. You don't want to breathe it in. So we'll be talking about that. We will be talking about, like on page 164, 165, about making the occupied bed. If you can make an occupied bed, which means the resident's in the bed, you can make an unoccupied bed. And virtually what you're doing is you're rolling the resident from one side to the other, tucking the linens in and then rolling them and then making half the bed, roll them and make the other half the bed. We're gonna be practicing on one another when we go to the back. But that is making an occupied bed. Okay, want to watch some of the DVDs here, basically, because sometimes seeing somebody doing something and then doing it yourself and kind of just aids to the learning process. While I'm getting this ready, you guys want to go take about a 5-minute break?
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, make it 10. Make okay. It about a 10-minute break. 10-minute break. Let me go ahead and turn this thing off real quick.